Everybody's looking for that something. One thing that makes it all complete. You'll find it in the strangest places. Places you never knew it could be. Some find it in the faces of their children. Some find it in the lover's eyes. Who can deny the joy it brings when you find that special thing? You're flying without wings.
Good morning, class.
Good morning, everybody.
How are you today?
Yeah, how are you?
Well, I'm okay. How are you, Beth?
I'm doing good.
Good. Are you ready
good.
Are you ready to impart some more knowledge to these wonderful students of ours?
I cannot tell the students how wonderful the assignments are. Oh, my gosh.
We thought that having 43 papers from over a three-day period would just floor us and just overwhelm us. I can't tell you how much fun it was.
Oh, my goodness.
To sit there.
Especially the gratitude logs.
Mm-hmm.
I love how everybody is finding every little thing to be grateful for because it creates so much more for them. And, oh, I just love them.
Well,
love them.
I can't tell you how your gratitude logs made me feel more gratitude.
Exactly.
It really is proof that how the law of attraction, if we all just use it and interact with it and have it weave in and out of our lives, it just makes the next person's life even better.
I know.
Your responses and your lessons made us feel so good.
I can't even tell you. And we want to let you know, we decided we were going to make comments on the actual paper assignments. But Lee and I decided...
Well, comments weren't enough, I don't think.
Yeah, so what we want to do is we want to put it in your personal locker. We're going to have all the paperwork that you sent us, and we're going to comment on it and answer the questions that you wanted to know the
answers
to as
well. We'll just hold your paper, and we'll go down, and we'll comment on line by line. And so you can just follow along with the
assignment
that you sent in.
So this week's lesson is... Bum, bum, bum!
Deconstruction! This is where boot camp starts. See, you know, in the military, boot camp starts with, you know, a shave and a haircut.
Yeah.
And a nice little uniform. And, you know, nice big meal.
Uh-huh.
And then comes the drill sergeant.
Well, we're not going to be drill sergeants as so much as we're going to ask you to kind of delve a little bit into your past, but to observe it, not to have any emotion attached to
it. No blame.
No blame.
No regret.
No regret. And you'll see as you read through the lesson what this means. And it does take concentration. But it is so important because once you finish this, then you go into what we call reconstruction of the self that you want to be in. That's how everything starts moving into life.
And then you fly from
that
point. So
the first thing we want to talk about are perceptions. And with perceptions, you know, everybody has different perceptions. You can be raised by the same two people or the same four people, family-wise, these days, and still come out with different perceptions than siblings. Just because the environment around may be just a little bit different for them, they have a little bit different personality anyway, and so... Two people with identical, and I mean identical, environments can turn out to be so different from a perception level. Wouldn't you agree, Lee?
Absolutely. If you were to ask one of my sisters, a specific question, and then ask me, I guarantee you all of those answers are going to be diametrically opposed.
Mm-hmm.
And they may come from the same space and the same feeling, but the answers are not going to be the same. And what changes that is the individual's perception.
That's right. And so all your perceptions that you have at this very moment, you created yourself. Some of them were pushed along by family members or your environment, but you and you alone are really responsible for your perceptions. You know, just like Lee just said about his family, we had for the very first time in many years all four siblings, counting me, together. And we were all recalling memories and incidents from when we were little kids, you know how you do. And it was just amazing to see how all four of us had a completely different view. Completely different view.
Well, it's kind of funny because one of Beth's siblings, the perception would all be that it all surrounded him, you know, this particular
mm-hmm.
brother.
That's right.
Another perception from another brother is how it affected through mom and dad's eyes,
mm-hmm.
your mom and dad's eyes.
That's right.
And then the third sibling would always look at it as some kind of conspiracy theory, how the government was responsible for what happened.
That's true.
Even if it was just, you know, falling off a log at a campsite. So, you know, you take these perceptions and while we can joke about it and all that and get amusement from it, in fact, what those perceptions can do is they can keep you from your goals with the law of attraction.
That's right. It's true. You know, when you have a perception, when you watch maybe your, well, it's in the lesson this week, when you watch your parents and you watch how they live their lives as a child, and you see that they are struggling and they are financially having problems and they're just working and working and working, your perception of work is going to be you work your fingers to the bone.
Until you die.
Yeah. And so that would be what my perception used to be before I knew about the law of attraction. And so that's really, believe it or not, what happened. I asked them from their point of view. They loved working. They had enough money. Now, they told me they didn't because they didn't want to give me money to blow on stereos and you know, tons of clothes. But see, my perception saw something completely different. So it's really important that we hone in on our perceptions, but we're going to hone in on where they came from so you can see, oh, that's how it happened. And so that's what we're going to do. Now, we want to make sure that you know we're not asking you necessarily to change any of your beliefs. Only the personal beliefs that are keeping you from what you desire. You know, many, many of our students have a philosophy, have a religion, and the law of attraction fits into every single one of them. That's not even an issue.
Mm-hmm.
So we're not asking you to give up anything like that. What we're asking you to give up is some of the personal beliefs that are actually keeping you from getting what you want.
Okay.
All right? So we have, let's talk about repetitious behavior patterns.
Well, repetitious behavior is probably the key to why things stop for you.
Mm-hmm. Or continue the same way.
Yes. Well, that's why. When you get into a repetitious behavior, your mind and your new perceptions that you might get are closed because they are so in concert with keeping that repetition going, that same block happening, that you don't have a chance to break out of that. And so the whole thing about repetitious behavior is, and we all have had it, what you're going to want to do during the deconstruction is you want to tag what your particular repetitious behavior is.
What that particular recording that's going on over and over and over again that's causing you to stay in a specific space that you don't want to be in.
And the easiest ways to see it is the dollars and cents ways. I think people who are having financial difficulties, they're the ones that are always going to be more locked into a repetitious behavior because, oh no, I don't want to try for that new job because I'm just going to have this job. Because if I try to the new job, I might not succeed, and I might lose what I have.
And then in the interim, what happens when the old job, if I do something to stop that old job, what's going to happen in between the old job and the new job? Where's that money going to come from? Oh, my gosh, where's the
So
the,
I'll stay the, put. I'll stay put.
Yeah.
I'll stay put. And that's what happens. That's the repetitious behavior. But I just use that as an example. It really can be in any instance of your life.
Health.